Hello and welcome to another tutorial series about the modular safety controller Flexi Soft. This time I'm going to show you how to use Flexi Line to connect up to 32 Flexi Soft stations together. In this video, we are going to start our project by configuring the hardware inside the Flexi Soft Designer. If you haven't downloaded the software yet, you can do this for free on sick.com/flexisoft. Let's start in the configuration. First of all, we need to add a CPU and one I/O module to create our example configuration. For the CPU, I choose a CPU 3, which offers the Flexi Line interface. For the I/O module, I'm going to choose an XT/IO, because it provides all in and outputs we need. Now we can add Flexi Line by going to Elements and then switching to Flexi Line. Via simple drag and drop, we add it to our CPU. A new window pops up and we choose to create a new Flexi Line definition. The Flexi Soft Designer automatically switches to the Flexi Line window, where we can configure the new definition. First of all, we need to do some general settings. On the left side, you can type in a name for your new definition, as well as a description. Furthermore, you can choose a major and a minor revision number. This number helps identifying the Flexi Line definition. The major number influences the checksum and therefore identifies incompatible definitions. The minor number, on the other hand, is used to distinguish further developed definitions, but has no influence on the checksum. That means that definitions with different minor version numbers are basically compatible. On the right side, you can specify the definition by selecting the bit number, the maximum length of cable, and the send cycle time. Because those three parameters are mutually dependent, not all combinations are possible. The FSD automatically colors them green or red to distinguish whether a combination is possible or not. All the settings on this page, except for the name, the minor version number, and the description affect the checksum, which is displayed on the left side. This checksum has to be the same in every Flexi Line station for the communication to be successful. In our example, we use 64 bits with a maximum cable length of 125 meters and 2 milliseconds send cycle time. Via the button byte configuration, we switch to another window where we can start creating the process image. Depending on a general setting, we see 4 to 12 bytes on the left side. Because we have chosen 64 bits as bit number, we have 8 bytes available. On the left side, we can select one of those bytes and then configure it with the settings on the right side. First of all, we can give every byte a name or write a comment for it. In our case, we want to create a global e-stop, so we call it e-stop. The most important part, however, can be found below. Here, we first have to choose the routing direction and the default value. The routing direction decides whether the byte is shared with all other stations, which would be global, or if it is only shared with the neighbors. Here, we can also decide if we want it to be shared with the previous station, the next station, or with both. In our example, we choose the first option because we are creating a global e-stop. The default value defines how the bit is influenced by a station. A bit with a default high will be high if all stations signal high for this bit. As soon as one station sets the bit to low, all other stations within the Flexi Line system will see this bit being low. For global e-stop, we have to pick high as default value, because it's a safety device which continuously needs to prove that it is active while the system is operating. Finally, we activate a bit of this byte by giving it a name, for example, global e-stop. All activated bits change their color from gray to blue, as you can see when I type in a name for the fourth bit. Now we can repeat those steps with the second byte to create a global restart. The only thing that changes is the default value, which has to be low in this case, because while the machine is operating, the restart button is not active. Of course, every change in the byte configuration affects the checksum of our Flexi Line definition. That's it so far for the first tutorial. We successfully created a Flexi Line definition with a global e-stop and a global restart. In the next video, we are going to export this to another station.